Hello and welcome to the third video of the character animation series. In this video, I'll discuss the basic workflow for character animation. This is the workflow I use for my own character animations, and I'm sure this workflow can help you deliver awesome looking character animations. So let's get straight into it. The first stage is planning. Now it's important that you plan your character animation right before you even touch Blender or any other 3D software. A project without any planning, in other words, if you go straight into Blender without any planning whatsoever, you are more likely to abandon your project. Thus, planning is essential to an animation project that is likely to succeed. So first of all, the story. The story must be awesome. You're probably going to be slaving for months. For example, 5 to 6 months for a probable 2 to 5 minute animation. Thus, you really must have a really, really good story. You need to have a story that you believe in, that you're motivated by. Because if you find that halfway that your story really isn't that good, you're probably going to give up. So make sure that your story is really good and that you have it down packed. So once you're happy with your story, you need to create a screenplay. Here's an example of a screenplay from my own animated short film, Vetri, which you can find on my YouTube channel. Please feel free to check it out if you're free. The screenplay must be clear and concise, covering the who, what, where, when, and why. So things like, where is the location currently? What time is it? What is your main character doing? What are the other characters in your scene doing? And so on. Read your screenplay again to make sure that it makes sense. And also have someone else read it to make sure that it's good. But if you want to keep it a suspense, then I guess it's okay. But make sure that you read it again by yourself to check that your story is flowing quite well. Second, you need to create a storyboard. There are many different ways of creating storyboards. For example, using GIMP and Photoshop and duplicating or copy-pasting boxes. In this example, I've drawn 10 boxes, which is a 2x5, yep, 10 boxes. And to draw my images, I used a Wacom tablet, which is a Wacom bamboo pen and touch tablet. You can buy this at any electronic store, and if you can't, then it should be available online to order. I recommend using a pen and touch tablet to draw rather than a mouse, because a mouse is very, very difficult. If you don't have access to a pen and touch tablet, please do not resort to drawing with a mouse, because it's almost like torture. Instead, just draw using a physical pen and paper, and then scanning using a scanner or something. And if you don't have a scanner, then just take a photo on your smartphone. That should be good enough. Another method of storyboarding, and this is a method that I use for my own short films, is actually bringing your characters into the scene and creating those poses and taking snapshots. I just have to say one thing. I'm not going to be providing the set or the characters in this series. We're not going to be doing any character modeling or set creation or anything like that. That might be for another series. Don't worry about it if you don't have any of these props and stuff. I'll show you how you can get this character. It's also for free. And for the set, you can just model any basic set. So just wanted to let you know that now. So where was I? In storyboard, clear poses are important. So for example, are the poses clear? Will the audience get it once it's refined? I chose this form of storyboarding, as I can simply reuse this scene when it's time to finally animate, and I don't have to create everything from scratch and things like that. So I guess I did contradict my own statement saying you should not touch Blender, but I guess for this case it should be okay. The next stage is taking reference footage. So this really helps in terms of timing. This is an actual snapshot of a reference video of myself. I had to blur it out for embarrassment and self-respect. So reference footage can actually help with understanding pose transitions as well. So make sure that you take good reference videos, as it can help you provide more realistic character animations with good timing. Once that's done, you have to create an animatic. So an animatic combines your storyboard images with the music in a video editor. The video editor, I also used Blender. But you can use any other video editor that you're comfortable with. The animatic is basically like your final film, only without the awesome film graphics and the visuals and things like that, and the music as well. It's important that you watch the animatic again or have someone else watch it with you to determine if the story flows quite well or if the timing needs to be readjusted and so on. Animatics are generally used by filmmakers to pitch their stories to potential film producers. In our case, we're using it to help us organize our character animation better. Finally, we can start to use Blender. So the second phase is blocking and refining. So here we can use the pose-to-pose method to build specific key poses at specific times. Having the reference video and animatic loaded up can help you with the timing easily. Once all the blocking is done, get feedback and then refine the blocking once again. And then do a second level of blocking and create poses in between the key poses. This is a term called breakdowns, and it helps to further shape the pose. So you keep on refining this way. So after you're done with all that blocking and refining, you basically should have your final animation ready. I mean, it won't look world class, it won't look smooth, it won't look great, your animation, but it should be clear enough, and you should be able to get away with it if you really can't be bothered doing polishing. But adding a polishing phase can really make your animations look better. It adds a bit more pop to your animations. But if you don't have polishing, then I think people will still be able to understand it, but they won't really say, it won't really be jaw-dropping, if you know what I mean. So that's why the polishing phase exists, because it makes your animations a lot better. So in the polishing phase, you can use the straight-ahead animation technique and animate between those poses. You can also go into the F-curves and make further tweaks to smooth everything out. And, yep, so you just keep refining this until you're happy with it. You can just, so this is all detailed kind of stuff. And I'll also obviously show you how I did that in another video. So once the scene is polished, you're pretty much finished. You can then render your completed work. And you can now see your work finally come to life in a completed animation project. And at this point, you should feel really satisfied and really excited that you're going to be showing your animation project to the whole world. And that's it. So I hope this video has helped you understand the workflow that generally goes into creating character animations. In the next video, I'll discuss the 5 most annoying things you'll probably come across when animating your own characters. Sort of a heads up now before we go in and actually animate our scenes. Please subscribe, share, and leave a comment as it helps me provide more quality tutorials. I hope you join me for the next video, and thanks for watching.